People say that I am the best dad. They say, we've never had a dad like you before. They say, you're hilarious. And that I make them the best they can be. I think this pretty much sums up everything you need to know right here. I got it from one of my daughters when she was little. I don't remember which one. Oh, that one. I don't remember her name.
Oh, nice practical joke, Jim, that Gabrielle is going to go graduate and go off to college.
No, 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 gosh, no, please, no, no, no!
I am not a big fan of fine art. I don't understand how it qualifies as fine. It is confusing. Sometimes it makes me dizzy. My girlfriend, Kate, recently took me to a Picasso exhibit at a local museum, and upon arriving, the very first thing I saw was a painting of a man. And his nose was here, and his mouth was here, and it was horrifying. It was neither fine nor even okay. It was scary. Fine art should make me happy. It should make me feel good. Like Mickey Mouse, or the Sports Illustrated Swimsuit Edition.
This is Prison Mike, and I'm here to tell you to stay in school and don't skip classes, or you end up like me, in prison.
What did you go to prison for?
I stole my mama's vodka, her Kettle One. So listen to your parents, don't steal their vodka, and don't be like Prison Mike.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the factual archival connection between Gabrielle alias Shannon and the Dinder Mifflin Paper Company, the office in Scranton, Pennsylvania. Yes, we have true historical data, true facts. Fact number one. Gabrielle descends from Samuel Adams of Virginia, a founding father, from famous Italians who come from Sicily, and from some rather bizarre Slovakian Eastern European immigrants who all converge in history in Binghamton, New York, where the families migrated south. They took the fork in the road and migrated from Binghamton, 58 miles south, to Scranton, Pennsylvania, where they developed. Oh, thank you, Granddaddy. Thank you so much. Where they developed the Scranton office people that we know and love. Yes, Samuel Adams, who was once our founding father, who fought against slavery, is now a beer. And from the American Revolution, they came from Virginia, they came from Scotland, they came from Slovakia, they came from Italy to become the office people. Yes, Scranton, Pennsylvania welcomes you.
Question. What kind of fashion is fab?
That's a ridiculous question.
False. Fleek fashion.
That's debatable. There are basically two
sides. Fact. My fashion is on fleek.
No.
Fashion. Fitness.
sleek. Your fashion is what's going on? What are you doing?
Last week I was on Amazon and I found these glasses, $45. And it only took my dad's closet to recreate the rest of the ensemble, which is a grand total of, Fitbit doesn't calculate.
You know what? Imitation is the most sincere form of flattery, so I thank you. Identity theft isn't a joke, Jibrielle. Millions of families suffer every year.
Your mom.
Oh, that's funny. Your mom.
Embracing our people with our something, we don't know what it is, because we're obsessed with the office. Yes, and here are now the two positive proofs that Gabrielle is one of the real office people. We'll begin with proof number one. Here it is. Fast forward Granddaddy's and Grandma's cabin. Gabrielle, she's young, she's a little girl. Grandmama buys her a sweet baby doll to sleep with. What does she name the sweet baby doll? Sweet baby? No, because she has that office mentality. She names the baby Stinky Baby. And Stinky Baby escapes out of Gabrielle's suitcase and stays behind at the cabin. Grandmama and Granddaddy rush back to the cabin, and what do we find? Stinky Baby drinking the vodka! True, true. Scranton office mentality. And the final proof. Yes, the final proof, ladies and gentlemen. Gabrielle comes back from Scotland, and she says to the Granddaddy that she loves him. And she goes to school, and they ask Gabrielle, Gabrielle, tell us something about your family. And she tells about her Granddaddy and her wonderful grandparents from New Orleans. And then, in the true office mentality, descending from Samuel Adams, who really fought against slavery, she says, and there's my black grandma. Yes, my black grandma. Our Gabrielle, the queen of the office people.
Here's a great example of fine art. This is art that is indeed fine. It's a picture of a field with some mountains in the background and some sheep. I am neither confused nor dizzy. In fact, I'm inspired. Calm. Made to be happy. This is fine art, not Picasso.
Ghosting time is over with. Big changes are coming and they're coming soon. And if you don't like it, see that over there? That's the door. You can walk through it. Now, first up, down. Your request for a night school has been approved by the company.
Seriously?
Full ride. Stone cold, seriously. Toby, you got a new chair.
Thanks.
Don't thank me. I'm not here to be your friend. I'm giving you a bowl of ice cream. Whether you like it or not, I don't care. Because it's going to be the same bowl of ice cream today as it will be on Ice Cream Thursdays.
These sound like good ideas, but I can see if some people might think they're not good ideas. I don't know what to think.
Oh my gosh, Kevin's got me pegged. They're trying to figure me out. I gotta figure out who's the good workers and who's the mind readers. And once I do that, then I don't care.
Sitting on my ticket with a cold Budweiser, calling man Khan to see what has aspired.
Yo, Lily, our town is dope and pretty.
So check out how we live
in Pirate City.
They call it Greenville.
What?
Pirate City, Greenville.
What?
Pirate City.
Arg, Greenville, they call it the Pirate City because we are ECU. City's laid out from east to west. And Jordan Library is truly the best.
Try to get green because it's built by the best.
Called poison control if you're bit by Petey.
But check that it's covered by your student health care provider.
Ain't no space in the parking lot.
Unless you want to pay $300 for a parking spot.
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 Spot. Spot. Spot.
Snack attack time.
Don't lose your head.
Ask Miss B for some tasty bread. They call it Greenville.
What?
The Pirate City. Greenville.
What?
The Pirate City. Greenville.
What?
I will give you an example. One day recently, I was driving to visit my girlfriend, Kate. And in the distance, a good ways in the distance, there was a billboard. And in the right-hand corner, in very small letters, were the words, fine art. And I thought, there you go. Confusing. Why do you have to put it in the smallest font in a little corner? You can make it big letters, but no, you have to be cute and confusing and fine. And then I got closer to the billboard and it actually said fire ants, which made a lot more sense, being that fire ants were actually on the billboard. So was a man in a uniform and a 1-800 number. And I thought, hey, that's fine art. I understand that. It makes me happy. And I got a really good deal on a year's worth of fire ant treatment.
This is parkour. Internet sensation of 2004. It was in one of the Bond films. It's pretty impressive. The point is to get from point A to point B as creatively as possible. So technically, they are doing parkour, as long as point A is delusion and point B is the hospital.
Today is the first day of Sabre's new project to launch retail stores across the country. I'm meeting with my new boss, Gabrielle Shannon. She's the head of new projects. Work starts at 9. Sabre HQ is 30 minutes away driving the speed limit, giving everyone 20 minutes to shower, plus 50 for Chas to style her hair, plus 20 for breakfast, plus 40 for Mabel to get lost between her room and the lobby, plus 90 for Annabelle to do her morning snacks. We're already 20 minutes late. You were reading the mattresses?
Wake up! Wake up! Wake up! Wake up! Wake up!
Wake up! Wake up!
I know what to do. Cover his mouth and his legs. Good! You're awake!
Look what I got. Hey! Those are my favorite, you know? Last night, I went downstairs to get two. Oh, that's not fair.
So currently, I'm on the three-kid schedule, which means I'm usually up, well, I am up by 4:15 every day. And since I don't have the kids with me, I had lots of extra time. So I got to thinking, Jack.
Oh, no. What kind of stuff did Chess get into last night? Oh, no. Jack did? No, I didn't. I didn't do it. Meet Gabrielle at ECU. Chess is dead.
I guess fine art is, at the end of the day, in the eye of the beholder of the art. To me, as I said, fine art should make me feel happy. And I have a couple of examples of some fine art pieces that I've been collecting through the years. This is my treasure box. I've had it for several years now. I keep poetry in this box. And it just so happens I had a poet who lived in my home for several years. Every day when she was little, she would leave little poems in my lunchbox. And I'd read them, and they made me happy. Dad, TGIF, love you. Hope you're not too busy. Hope your day is great. Gabs. I've got hundreds of them, little poems that I read when I'm sad, and they make me happy. That's pretty fine art. And as I said, Mickey Mouse also makes me happy.
Reflecting back on the last 17 plus years of your life, we knew from the moment you were born that you were tough and you were special. You went out, you came out, you know, we as purple, and maybe you're going into college purple as well, but you are a fighter from the moment you were born. Not gonna let anything get you down. Through three broken arms, busted eardrums, to a mean big sister, and a you were always one of the most stoic, tough kids. I mean, heck, who gets known as Fist of Steel for being, you know, girly and sweet? Well, you are sweet too. But I was gonna say, as I think now to the years that have passed and how you have grown from that little girl to this young lady, I just wanna say, thank you for this last year in particular and the special times that we've had together with training for our races and early morning workout routines. And to our spring break inside jokes, you know, Farquaad, and to just the sweet times that we've had together lately. You have made it hard to say goodbye to you, but I know that you are right. It'll be good. I love you and I'm proud of you.
I saw a friend today, it had been a while. We forgot each other's names, but it didn't matter, 'cause deep inside the feeling still remained the same. We talked of knowing one before you met, and how you feel more than you see, and other worlds that lie in spaces in between. And angels you can see, and all the faces that I know have that same familiar glow. I think I must have known them somewhere once before, all the faces that I know, and all the faces we see each and every. When I get home at night, you're the face I need. And when my mind's absorbed on my private little screen, and I'm walking blind through a sea of unknown men, I hear a voice reminding there across the street walks an old forgotten friend. We don't have to say a word. It's really better left unsaid. Just lights through eyes that recognize all the faces that I know. All the faces that I know. And all the faces we see each and every day. get home at night. You're the face I need when I get home at night. You're the only face I need.
Two, three.